an artist today that was mentored by Boy George in The Voice. And Boy George is famous for being in Culture Club and being just Boy George and those hats and that personality. But one of the personalities that he mentored in season 5, I think it was, way back, was Cody Frost. And she's gone on, out of 4 tracks on a mini EP she's released, she released this particular track that I'm featuring today called I Should Take Better Care. Now, the title itself should resonate with you and you should be able to go, oh, well, maybe it's about taking care of yourself. It is, mentally. To allow the physical to heal as well. And it's something I say a lot in my videos. So Cody, I already relate to you. The girl herself has caused a bit of controversy because what happened on The Voice when George was mentoring her was she got through to the final, fell at the first hurdle. She didn't win that particular season. George was mentoring her. But the fans felt very angry that she fell and that it was a fix. And there's no way, because she was so, so popular, nobody could believe that she was out of the competition in the first part of the final. But she went on to say, Cody, that she was delighted she didn't go on to win the actual show itself, simply because it gave her a platform to be known by yourselves and myself and other people, and to allow her music to flourish naturally with her own songwriting skills, which are phenomenal and you're about to hear. But it also, she didn't want to, but also she didn't want, I believe, to sing the winner's song. She felt that kind of cover, that kind of interpretation wasn't really her. It didn't speak to the soul. So she was quite happy to leave at a very high point, but the fans were, woof, I believe, very, very angry at the time. But Cody Frost is a person that has alternative electronic music style, perfect for the people who wish deep music and people who wish alternative music. And when I say alternative, I've seen her in more current recent videos taking a musical change to become more grunge, more garage music. These are old musical terms for underground music that I haven't heard in a while, but this is the kind of twist musically that she's taking and the path she's following. I hope she keeps ballads in her playlist and that she performs them and that she writes them, because when you hear her writing skills, when you hear her voice to her own writing skills that are simply incredible, the prowess of this young woman is just mind-blowing. It really is. You'll hear her in a minute. Now, this is what it says about her. Alternative electronic music for the melancholic, angry and confused people who are just simply floating about in space is what Cody Frost is about and what and whom she writes for, because that's how she describes herself. Because I guess that's what I can be sometimes, she says. It's also for people who are misunderstood, and anyone will listen to me. And I can't use profanity on YouTube. I'm Cody. I'm 26 years old, singer, music maker and tattooer from the northwest of the UK in a little known town called Milltown in Burley. I've been singing since I was able to talk. My mum was a singer and pulled me on stage sometimes. In brackets, not my finest hour. I used to post covers weekly on YouTube from about 13 years of age and gradually built a following. When I was a teenager, I used to busk in Manchester with a nylon guitar covered in band stickers with no microphone. It definitely had its challenges. I've been working on my own songs properly for about 9 years now with my producer, Dan Weller, and working in different genres. Mind-numbing retail jobs kept me busy up until then, and being able to pursue my second dream, tattooing. I just released at the time of this particular research, my first 2 singles, Verbal Warnings and Hi Bye. Now, her influences. I started out finding my Chemical Romances, Welcome Back to the Black Parade, as one of them, on a computer that we'd been given when I was about 10. This was the first band I ever got into. This led to the love of all things emo, And that sort of evolved into getting me into heavier stuff, like Korn, Parkway Drive. Then, oh, who are my biggest influences? She says, later I got into reggae and ska, and the Skints were part of that. And now finally, She Breathes, I'm like into 100 Gecs, and that was at the time of this research. So the influences, and then share with us an interesting anecdote about one of your songs. The song Verbal Warning, she said, was one of the first songs I wrote. It's actually about 8 years old now. You are sent to Mars, no check-in baggage, and you can take one record. Which one? Probably Lost Boys movie soundtrack, best film, best movie score of all time. If you were to be described as an animal, which one would you be? They asked. Maybe one of those skinny dogs that have a nervous jacket on. We are proudly subculture inspired. How about you? Me too. I've been through a couple of phases, taking an inspiration from past subcultures. I love punk, emo, and even have a little goth in me sometimes. Not just in fashion, but also music and art. And I think they're all connected, though really you can't have one without the other. So that just gives you a little bit of an insight into it. Today's song by Cody Frost explores the themes of mental health, personal struggles, and the need for self-care. The song reflects on the internal battles and demons that everybody faces in their life. And what else does she say about it? She says the song is about the process of admitting that you're struggling. And a lot of us don't. I find it hard to admit when I'm sad or when I need help. So the song is a reminder that I'm not the only one. And with that, we'll listen to this very deep-rooted song that will touch you. I just find her fascinating. I feel she's multifaceted, multi-dimensional in her talents, and she's going to have a lot to offer over and over again over the years as she explores different genres, writes for different categories of music, and doesn't define herself in a box with one genre. That makes her more and more interesting, and I just see a huge future for her. Boy George mentioned that this particular song brought him to tears, and so I put it on a special thumbnail. I think it will as well. Don't forget, if you need the translation, hit the translation button for it to come up. The words are deep, and we'll discuss them straight after.
Cliche. It's making me insomniac. I'm not fighting personal demons. These are just demons we all have to face. And I'm not fighting personal demons.
Well, everybody, it goes to prove don't judge a book by its cover. If I had looked at her through pictures, I'd say she's a punk and just put her in a category and just boxed her and tied it up and thrown it away. As regards not her talent, but as regards how she looked, I would have just presumed. But you'd never think, would you, looking at somebody so alternative in the way that they portray themselves as having such a phenomenal voice. And that last note that she held, it's simply incredible. I can imagine live, she is everything. She was live on the show that when Boy George mentored her in The Coach. Check it out on YouTube, her performances, because honestly, you'd be blown away. And you can see why the fans were really angry that she fell at the first hurdle. But as she said, she didn't want to sing the winning song, and she was delighted to have got the platform, got the recognition, and moved on. And so am I, Cody, because I wouldn't have come across you only for I was looking into a Boy George song that I wanted to feature on my channel, and then you came up with him. So there you go. Connections, connections, connections. Let's go into what the whole song is about now and the meaning. In the first verse, the dying plants on the windowsill symbolize neglect and the effects of not taking care of oneself. This sets the tone for the song and introduces the idea that Cody's emotional state is reflected in her physical environment. The line, "Everything's to be going fine, but I'm holding your hand and you're not holding mine," conveys a sense of isolation and loneliness, suggesting that despite external appearances, Cody feels emotionally disconnected or disbanded. The refrain, "Call me cliche, call me a blag, call me a child, but please call me back," suggests a plea for attention and understanding. It highlights that vulnerability of Cody, expressing a desire to be acknowledged, validated in her struggles. The line, "I feel like my brain is under attack, making me an insomniac," illustrates an intense mental anguish and emotional turmoil experienced by Cody. It emphasizes the toll that all the demons are taking place within her mind. The chorus goes on, the phrase, "I'm not fighting personal demons, these are just demons we all have to face," enforces for me personally the universality of her struggles, emphasizing that everybody, which is true, hold up my hand, I'm one of those people that have suffered mentally, that we've all suffered those kind of demons in our lives. We have, Cody, we certainly have. You're not on your own, and as you said, the song is about touching people to say they're not on their own. And listen, everybody, not just Cody, not just myself, if you're experiencing dark clouds, don't worry, you're not on your own, and light will come. Karma will come to help you. It will. None of us are meant to suffer in this world. None of us. Just remember that. And the use of the word demons, it's a metaphorical representation of internal conflicts, that's all. Those negative emotions, the mental health issues that come when you're feeling you're on your own and I can't cope with life or what's happening. And it doesn't justify. The great thing about this song is it's not just in the lyrics. It's not defining a love situation. It's defining a point of life where you feel you're on your own because you just can't cope. That's it. And we've all been there. And as you said, the line, where is it? Okay, I should take better care of myself, but I couldn't. Ask anybody to understand my mental health is such a powerful, powerful deliverance of this song because it highlights the difficulty for all of us in that situation in expressing and seeking support for your mental well-being. We don't like to admit that we have mental problems. None of us do. None of us do. And it emphasizes the importance of self-care, which is very true. I've always said turn the negatives into positives in every video. And instead of saying, I cannot believe I can, for the mental to help the physical. Just remember how you think reflects how what people see in your face and how you are physically. So turning that around and believing you're going to have a good day and you're going to get through something, something positive is going to happen. Even if it doesn't, it's a chance you need to get into to allow positivity into a mind of isolation and darkness. So it emphasizes that importance of self-care, which is important, and acknowledges those challenges of finding and understanding empathy with others. Overall, Cody Frost's I Should Take Better Care for me is a message of self-awareness, the significance of those personal struggles we all face at some point, and the need to take care of yourself and not let yourself go and not give in to the darkness and all of that. Empower yourself with positivity. It reminds listeners that everyone faces their own demons. We do. And taking care of oneself mentally and emotionally, as I've mentioned, is crucial. The song encourages and understands empathy towards those who may be struggling with mental depression and mental issues and serves as a reminder. And this is the important thing, that seeking help, go on Google, mental health problems, look in the helpline number, and practicing, in other words, believing you're going to have a good day when you go to bed, light a candle or read a book or think of something positive or give your dog a hug or that kind of thing, is important for overall well-being. And that's what it's about. I hope you've enjoyed Cody Frost's first appearance on my channel. She'll be back. She's exceptional. Take care for now, everybody. Have a great week. Think positive, be positive, and keep that door open to positivity always.